first ride got cancelled and finally I got a Grab driver. What is your name, brother?
Yes, I am. Hello.
So, yeah, he is going to take me actually to Ubud right now. I'm definitely going to miss Noosa Penida a lot. The experience here was surreal, and trust me, this is going to be missed for a very long time. So after a lot of bargaining, we're starting from 400,000 idea, so it came down to finally 300,000 idea. So that is almost around like 1500 per night. So hello and welcome back to the channel. Right now I am at Noosa Penida, and in this video I'll be going from Noosa Penida to Ubud, and I'll be showing you what are the costs and all which we'll have to pay for going from Noosa Penida to Ubud. As you all know that I have checked out actually from my hotel before going for the beaches actually on the east side, like the Diamond Beach and also the viewpoints and all. So I did that actually in the last video. I've checked out from my hotel in the last video, and this is actually a continuation of that same video. So let's go. As it's almost 4 o'clock right now, and hopefully I'm going to get the ferry which is actually timed at 4:30, or else if I miss that I will be going on the 5 p.m. ferry actually. So without wasting much time, let's get started with the journey, and if you have any queries related to anything, do let me know in the comment section below. So come on, let's start our journey towards the harbor here at Noosa Penida. On the right hand side you can see the beautiful beach out here, and on the back side you can see Mount Agun, which is one of the highest peaks here in the country. It will take me around 15 to 20 minutes time to reach the harbor from here. So let's go. So I've reached the harbor and it's almost 4:25 at the clock. Let's see if I can get the 4:30 ferry from here, from the jetty. First I have to submit, or I have to give the bike back to the person who actually is calling right now. Hello, at the harbor gate, harbor gate. So basically he called for the bike because it's already 4:30 at the clock. Yeah, there he is standing. I came on time.
Good, yeah. It's good.
Okay, see you, brother. See you again, man. Okay, so this is the harbor area from where we will actually be coming, if you are coming from Ubud or Kuta. And so as I've already told you, it's around 140,000 is what he charged me for the bike for 2 days, which is almost around 750 Indian rupees. Right now I'm walking towards the jetty to get my boat. I have actually booked round tickets actually from Kuta to Noosa Penida, and that has costed me almost around 1500 Indian rupees. 300,000 was the price which I paid for the ticket round trip. So let's go. So this is the harbor here, and there's some construction work going on in this particular place. That's why this place is at a mess right now. And this is the ticket actually, the return ticket of mine, which I will have to show. written here, and I will be telling you about it a bit later. First let me see if I can get the 4:30 ready from here to Kuta or to the Sunroof Port. Sorry. There's a huge queue here for what I don't know. Let me just check on that first. Oh, where is this one?
This Babu.
Which one? Okay. So there are a lot of agencies actually who are providing ferry service here from Sanur and also from Padangbai to Nusa Penida. So the company from which we are actually connected here are Simabu Hills Fast Boat. So let me see whom I find from that company first. So I guess there are ticket counters here just like what they have in Sanur. Let me just search by the name Simabu Hills. No. Where is this ticket counter?
There.
Yeah, okay. So basically right now I'm in search for the ticket counter here. I don't know where. I might miss this one. Okay, thank you. Where do we wait here? There at the harbor?
You just wait here, yeah?
Okay, thank you. Well, the 4:30 slot is already full booked, and they have given me this thing, which they also have given me from when I was coming from Sanur to this island. 5 p.m. is my boat to the Sanur harbor. So I will have to wait for the next 20 minutes. Let me see if I can have some food from here, because I'm literally starving right now. So let me give you some information here. If you are going from Nusa Penida to Ubud, then the nearest harbor from you for you will be the Padangbai harbor. But as because I am coming from Kuta and from Sanur, by the way, so I took round ticket trips from Sanur to Nusa Penida. That actually was a bit cheaper when you take round trip tickets, and from there I will be booking a bike or a grab directly to Ubud, which will take me around 45-50 minutes time to reach. So you can do that if you want, or else if you are going on a single way ticket, on a one way ticket, then I would suggest that if you are coming here, then directly take tickets for Padangbai if you want to go to Ubud, and if you want to go to Kuta, then go for the Sanur harbor. I'm definitely going to miss Nusa Penida a lot. The experience here was surreal, and trust me, this is going to be missed for a very long time. So basically it will take almost around 45 to 50 minutes time for me to reach from Nusa Penida to the Sanur harbor, and there are a lot of agencies with lot of different boats like this, boat companies by the way, out of which Axtone is the one who is the fastest. They normally take 30 minutes time to go from one spot to other, and the prices there are almost 20 to 30% more. So I won't definitely suggest you all to go for that. In case if there is any emergency, then I would say that you can go, but else 15 minutes you can like easily. I don't think for 15 minutes you should pay 20-30% extra on the price for your ferry tickets.
So this is the boat which will take us to the Sanur harbor.
Okay, so you can see this is the boat
or the ferry. And on the same one we came from Sanur. Excuse me. And on the same way we came from Sanur to the Sapinida Islands.
Well, that's because it's the last boat of the day. There is a delay, and the delay is almost 15 minutes as of now. I hope they are going to take 15-20 minutes more actually. So hopefully we are going to start our journey 5:30 PM and we'll reach by 6:15 maximum or 6:30. The basically major problem here for me is that from there I will actually have to book a grab and again go for an hour to Ubud. So when I reach Ubud, it will be late evening. So let's see what happens, because after that I have to find some hotel and book. So I'll keep on showing you and also updating you on what I do.
This is the Sanur ferry, or the Sanur harbor as they say, and it took me around 45 minutes time to reach this particular place, and it's actually going to take me almost around an hour to reach Ubud from here. I have not booked anything yet, so I will just go and find some hotel or hostel first. But before that, let me just show you this beautiful place here. You can see the harbor looks absolutely beautiful. It's just a design of a fish, as you can see. Right there is the tail, and this side is the head, and it's beautiful. The sunset looks very beautiful from this place as well. So this is the arrival hall here, and you can see that these are places from where you can actually collect your baggages, places to sit. It's quite a big harbor actually, and the popular one here in Bali. And right outside you can see the parking areas are there. So this is what a grab is going to cost me. As you can see, 63,000 Indonesian rupiah, which is almost around 320 rupees from Sanur port to Ubud center. So I'm going to book this one right over here. Okay, so there is another option of 61,000, by the way, so I'm choosing this one. So let's book. Okay, so when you are coming to the Sanur harbor from Kuta or any other place, right over here, this is the place is actually closed right now. This is the place where you will be actually buying the tickets from. The entire section is dedicated to the ticket agencies here, and this is from where I also got my tickets. Just remember one thing, you have always an option to bargain. I did bargain and got a better price than what they were asking me for, and that too on a season time. So keep this thing in mind when you are coming down here.
Well, just like the airport here in Bali, they don't allow grab pickups to happen just outside the harbor gate. I don't know why, but trust me, this is not good actually. I have to literally walk almost around 600-700 meters, just like this, as you can see it on the backside. People are waiting here, but they won't allow you to actually book online. They will take you, they will charge you double. So this is bad actually, and I have already lost more than 30 minutes on the way, and it will take me almost an hour to reach. So when I reach there, it will be almost around 8:30, and it will be difficult for me to find a good hotel or hostel at that point of time. So my first ride got cancelled, and finally I got a grab driver. What is your name, brother?
Yes, I am.
Yes, I am.
Hello.
So yeah, he is going to take me actually to Ubud right now. and it will take almost around 1 hour to reach. So it's already 6:45 at the clock, so hopefully by 7:45 we are going to reach the Ubud Center. So come on, let's go. Okay, so it's almost 8 at the clock right now and I have reached the Ubud Center area. The main road is just around 100 meters from here, but it's a one way, so he dropped me right in the middle. But it's okay actually, why will he take risk for me, by the way. So let me find some hotel or homestays or bungalow, I don't know. But what I can see here, the place is actually a bit more happening than what I was expecting, to be honest. So come on, let's go and find something first.
Well, for after searching for almost around 30-40 minutes, I found a very beautiful bungalow cum villa here, and I'm going to show you how beautiful it is, because this is actually what an authentic Balinese house looks like. They have the swimming pool right over there, and let me just show you the room first, and I will be showing you how beautiful this particular bungalow area is tomorrow on the next video actually, because right now it's already dark. So let me just show you the room first. So right over here is the room. It's quite spacious, as you can see. Along with that, they have ceiling fan also with AC, and this is the basin area along with the cupboards and all, and right here is the washroom. So this is actually I did a lot of bargaining with the owner, and he just had this particular room, and I'm going to stay here for the next 4 nights. So I told him, look, you give me a good rate, because there are a lot of hotels and hostels there and homestays, so I don't want to even talk about it. So give me a rate which I can actually digest and I can stay. So after a lot of bargaining, you're starting from 400,000 idea, so it came down to finally 300,000 idea. So that is almost around 1500 per night. So I guess it's a good deal, because nearby places I've seen, they are not actually providing anything within this range. All are almost 350 to 400k. so it's a good deal that I got, and hopefully I'm going to enjoy Ubud just like I enjoyed Kuta and Nusa Penida. So I'm ending this video right over here. If you have any queries related to anything, do let me know in the comment section below. And from tomorrow onwards, or in the next video, I'll be starting to explore Ubud with you guys. So do watch the series and keep following the channel. Bye bye, take care.